not completed, and no credit. Those are the terms Bryan Nehman talked about as he went into the news break, because those now, Bryan, will replace in the Baltimore City public school system the unsatisfactory and the fail words. Those words are no longer used. You can't use those words because we all know what COVID-19 and the pandemic has done to our learning environment, and kids have, for the most part, not done well. And a lot of kids have done worse than that well. In Baltimore City, Bryan, according to the Baltimore City School Board, they unveiled last night in their virtual meeting that 65% of secondary students and 50% of elementary school students are at the failing level at least in one class, which means probably a whole bunch more, okay? But at least in one class. And instead of holding them back and making them repeat their grade, whatever that grade may be, they're going to advance them to the next grade, with the caveat, though, that they must do all the work of the next grade. I have a big problem with this. I have a very big problem with this. And I just, as a former person who taught, not in public schools, I taught a youth entrepreneurship course, I would not allow my students who had not done the necessary curriculum work that I had, we had a 12 workbook curriculum, to move to the next level until they completed the work. Now, it doesn't mean that you have to label them a failure, Bryan. Hmm. I'm not saying you call them a failure, but if the work, because of the virtual nature of things, prevented them from completing things, have them complete it first and then move them to the next grade.
Yeah, they shouldn't carry this on them if they didn't do well or were not able to do the same type of work that they normally would because of the pandemic. I've right. always thought that we have just, for whatever reason, labeled the failing or repeating a grade as this the worst thing that could ever happen to you. No,
it's more on the school system than it is on the kids. Okay?
Yeah. Well, right. Well, that's the problem. But, you know, we're flush with money, so why would it be a big issue for them to say, you know, though these kids have to go back? Look, the caveat that you talked about of them having to know the work or to do the work, I am skeptical of that. I'm extremely skeptical that that will actually happen.
You should be.
Well, because
with the history of social promotion in our school system, not just in Baltimore City, but across the country, where we have in Maryland, Bryan, according to the last study, 50%, probably 52% of our high school graduates needed remediation in math and English when they got to college. Those are zero credit courses that you still pay for that right. you got to take because you didn't get what you needed in our public schools.
So you don't get an E anymore or an F or whatever it is in high school for Baltimore City. It was always an E when I was in high school. You didn't
yeah.
even have Fs anymore.
Well, we had Fs when I was in school. Show you how
okay,
I am.
So you get a no credit. All right, so what does the no credit mean? When do I wind up getting credit for it? Do I actually have to pass a test in order to
well,
they're
going to individualize
it.
They said last night they're going to individualize, which I do like. I like this part. They're going to individualize this where they determine where you are as a student, not where your class is, not where your grade is, and be able to get you to the point okay. where you have learned and mastered the
All
material.
Right. Riddle me this. This right. is the part I can't figure out. So I'm in Spanish 1 this year uh-huh. as a ninth grader. I'm scheduled to take Spanish 2 next year. So when I go to school in the fall, am I in Spanish 2 or am I in Spanish 1? And do I have to take a test to determine where I was in Spanish 1?
You are
1?
In Spanish 2, okay, and so they're saying that you are going to have to master all of Spanish 1 and Spanish 2 before you move forward. I don't believe that.
Right.
I don't believe that's going to happen. And that's my problem is we have to stop. And this is part of this whole self-esteem as opposed to academic success that's in public schools now that Bryan and I were talking about earlier in the show. The kids' self-esteem today is much more important than what they know, than what knowledge they've gained.
Yes. It's totally about that. That's why we can't say that they failed. That's why we
right.
can't say that they were unsatisfactory.
Correct.
That's why we have, you know, new names for everything, for being hungry. We have new names. We do. I mean, it's just everything is it's the so
you're financially challenged instead of being poor.
Yes. You know, well, I mean, it's food insecurity, which is like, right. what does that mean? Whoever says stuff like that, it's just dumb. It's not punitive. And that's what they talked about. They said they to hold them back is punitive. It's not punitive.
No, it isn't.
It is actually helping them learn.
It's reality.
To get to the next level of life.
It's the fact that if you have not mastered the material, then help them do that. That's why I talked about the summer experience, Bryan. What we need to be hearing from the Baltimore City School Board and CEO, Dr. Santelices, as well as the other jurisdictions, what are you planning from today, from May 26th until the fall? Okay, you tell us what you might do in the fall. And by the way, this decision is the first we've heard, Bryan, from any school district. And the Baltimore Sun is saying it might be one of the first in the country about what the fall looks like for schools and for parents in terms of stuff. But between now and then, what are you going to do?
I don't know.
Are you just going to let them, like, you know, just sit around? Or what's happening?
What's the plan in the summer to get the, exactly. to catch them up to speed on all of this? 410-467-WBAL is the phone number. You can also text us on the Metro Bath and Tile text line, 410-467-9225. Here's what also I'm concerned about. So that Spanish 2 class really becomes a Spanish 1.5 class, 1.5 class, or a 1.25 class. What about those kids who did well, who got B's and A's in Spanish 1 and are ready for Spanish 2? So then they get held back.
You can't make those kids feel bad because the other kids did well, Bryan. Don't you know that's seriously, look at the way that academically excellent programs now are being watered down or they're attempting to remove those because the kids are doing much better in those programs than other public school kids.
I grant you there's no great answer to this on how best to handle this because you can't have half of the school repeating the grade. That becomes problematic from a scheduling standpoint and from just a logistical standpoint. But it's also not okay to just say, yeah, we're going to put them to the next grade. We're going to give them a no credit and allow them to see where they are come September.
It's
and
a backdoor social promotion, and they don't want to call it that. As a matter of fact, the Baltimore Sun, the specialist from Johns Hopkins, talks about, you know, we don't, you know, want to socially promote, but we want to do. No, this is social promotion. What you are doing is you're saying, because the adults messed up, because we didn't have you in school and had virtual learning that was not, you know, optimum, that we're moving you to the next grade, even though you haven't done the work. That's social promotion.
Yeah. Well, David Steiner, the guy you're talking about from Hopkins, who is head of their education policy, said that it was a courageous decision. And I completely disagree with that. To me, this was the easy decision to make. The courageous decision was to say that we are going to grade you and that we're going to make sure that you have some master of the subject before we put you to the next grade. That would be the hard decision to make. This is the easy
one
to say.
And it's not saying they fail. And that's why, you know, I get so disturbed when they make it an either or, like a Hobson's choice. Either you move them to the next grade or you say they fail. No. What you explain to the young people is, look, before we can move you to the next grade, we have to make sure that you're doing well in this, this, that, and that. That is completely different than saying they failed.
Yeah. I'm worried, too. This just becomes an excuse for the next 5-10 years from the school systems to say, well, our numbers are down. The kids are not testing as well. Our graduation rate may be down slightly. And it's because of COVID, because of the slide that we saw in 2020.
It is going to be
why they should have been in school, by the way.
And that's what this validates. To me, what this validates are the decisions that were made last September, August, really. That's when this last stuff came up. August, that kids could not be in school. And we saw Dr. Karen Salmon and Governor Hogan traveling around to the few school districts back last September that did open their doors. I'd like to see how well they're doing. We don't get enough reports about some of the public school systems that were open compared to what the ones that were closed had, Bryan.
Yeah, right. I'd also like to see the comparisons, and I'm sure the private schools won't do this because they don't want to put out their information.
Right.
But what's their baseline level of learning was compared to today compared to what it was in September of 2020, if there was as much learning loss at the private school level as there is at the public school level.
Well, here's a text message. You can text us on Metro Beth and Tile text line 410-467-9225. See, for Bryan, my daughter has been teaching Saturday school at an elementary school in Baltimore County to catch kids up. See, that's what we should be talking about. Between now and September, what can we create that gets kids caught up between now and then?
And trying to make sure that parents take their kids to school or get their kids on a bus or however they get to school for them to do it, too. Look, this isn't all on the schools. This isn't all on the teachers. This
Absolutely
isn't all on the teachers'
right.
union. There is a parental responsibility. There is a child responsibility to try to do the work, to actually show up. Half the battle is showing up, and we just heard in the news that, you know, the lowest number when it comes to
Baltimore City, 79%
attendance is Baltimore City. That's got to change. And in order to get the kids learning again, they actually have to go to school And
so
be
on that
really
point,
learned.
Bryan, getting back to our achievement gap discussion, and everybody worried about, you know, because we need Kerwin to help reduce this achievement gap, we need all this money from the federal government. If you are advancing young people to the next grade and they don't have the skills to do so, who gets hurt the most in that situation, Bryan? The children at the lower end of the economic scale and who don't have support systems at home, they're the ones that really fall through the cracks at that point.
Right. All right. Here's somebody's challenging us. And a taxer says, no, what they are saying is that because of a once in a century pandemic, that we shouldn't hold the kids back and that we'll adjust the curriculum accordingly.
What does that mean?
Jeez.
What does adjust the curriculum accordingly mean? Jeez. What does that mean?
Well, that sounds nice,
but what does that mean? Does that mean not teach them the material that they needed and just go with the material now? What does that mean?
That means they're going to try to get a little bit of, if you just use the Spanish 1 analogy, do a little bit of Spanish 1, mix in with a little bit of Spanish 2, and go slowly. But at the end of the day, you are going to the next grade with
regardless,
and you're going to wind up being in Spanish 2, and Spanish 2 is not going to be as rigorous as it was before the pandemic.
And we will make sure that you pass Spanish 2 with some lower grade that's just enough, right, the 60 level, or was it 59, and they were grading up? Remember, we were talking about that from our Project Baltimore, was 59 and greater. That's what you – these scenarios are set up because you're trying to skirt and get around the real hard work it takes, Bryan, to educate kids. It's not easy. Look, one of the things I've said over and over again, if you want to think teaching is easy, go in a classroom and try to do it as a teacher. So it's not easy to teach, but it's also something that you shouldn't skirt or try to get around with quick fixes.
Yeah. The check says, after the year they had, I don't think any teachers will sign up to teach summer school. I've wondered about that, although I'm going to guess that the pay is going to be pretty nice.
I'll put it this way. I bet you more teachers than not would, considering how much they care about their kids. I know too many teachers, Bryan, that are so upset right now that their kids are so academically behind that they're not so mercenary that they would just say, I'll see you in September. Now, some of them might. I'm not saying all of them, but a lot of them I know would say, this year, for this emergency, I would sign up for summer. I would do it.
I'll show you a quarter of the teachers in my county who are home right now, not in the classroom. That's what I'll show you.
That's going to stay with Bryan Nehman.
Yeah, it will for probably the rest of my life. News brought to you by DriveEasyMD.com. We keep Maryland moving.